Beaver Falls has connections to many of America's pioneering industrialists. Here along 7th Avenue in Beaver Falls stands one of those reminders, the Carnegie Free Library. Beaver Falls was a borough of just over 6,000 residents in 1883, when a group of local citizens organized a new venture aimed at bringing a public library to the industrial community. A short time later, a small library was opened in a grocery store at 7th Avenue and 12th Street. In 1888, noted Pittsburgh steel magnate Andrew Carnegie, then 53 years old, arrived in Beaver Falls to purchase the Hartman Steel Company. This one business venture was merely a drop in the bucket to Carnegie, and the industrialist used his wealth to enhance the communities that his mills occupied. Although he spent little time in Beaver Falls, the town decided to appeal to his good nature. In 1899, the people of Beaver Falls formally asked if Carnegie would finance a public library for the town. An agreement was made, and in September 1899, Carnegie pledged $50,000 to the effort. Two lots were purchased at the corner of 7th Avenue and 13th Street, and construction began in late 1901. Prominent Pittsburgh architect Frederick J. Oesterling was procured to design the new library, a massive neoclassical style structure. On September 21st, 1903, the new Carnegie Free Library of Beaver Falls opened to the public. It was the 20th library in America constructed under financing from Andrew Carnegie. From 1916 to 1931, the library's second floor served as classrooms for the 8th graders of Beaver Falls School District. It has also served as home to historical societies and continues to be a meeting place for civic and community groups of all kinds. In 1971, the Carnegie Free Library became part of the new Beaver County Library System. Few buildings in Beaver Falls are as recognizable as the Carnegie Free Library. It has stood here for 114 years and will continue to educate and endear itself to the citizens of this city.